More than two decades later, a controversial statue of Nathan Bedford Forrest that could be seen from Interstate 65 is now down. Crews toppled it this morning. Our News Force Tosin Fakile was there and joins us live. And Tosin, I was there in Memphis when a similar statue went down just a few years ago. I'm sure there's people for and against this move.
That's right, Morris. People either liked the statue or they were against it. Some of them actually here as that statue came down. That controversial statue you could see from driving on the Interstate 65 above those trees in front of those flags. And right now, that statue is gone from the view of drivers and those who have lived in this area for a long time.
It's always been an eyesore.
People did not shy away from their thoughts on the removal of the controversial statue of the Confederate general and Grand Wizard of the KKK.
I'm glad it's gone. It was time, way time, for any number of reasons.
Indifferent overall, but it seems to me that, you know, it is part of history and part of the Southern culture or the existence of the South.
The Nathan Bedford Forrest statue, which had been vandalized several times, sat on the private property owned by this man, Bill Doris, who was aware that people were unhappy with the statue.
It was ugly.
I hope nothing unfortunate happens in the situation of the removal of the statue.
The statue you could see from I-65 is no longer there. And that's good news for Senator Heidi Campbell, who was out this morning in front of the property hoping to see it leave.
Over the course of several years, I tried hard to get it to state to let vegetation grow up on the highway around it because it's private property, so we couldn't obviously ask to have it taken down, but we could ask to not see it because it's hurtful. On the very year that the Nathan Bedford Forrest statue in the Capitol came down, to have this heinous statue come down, I think is just great. I'm really happy that we no longer have to look at it.
One Nashville man says he sent this letter to the attorneys of the estate of the private property willing to pay $10,000 for the controversial Bedford Forrest statue.
What we would do is just demolish it, make it a public event, throw a big party, and try to raise some money for some local charities at the same time.
Now, Brian, who you just heard from, Sarah, says he wanted to make sure he put enough offer for this to get the statue to make sure that they don't turn him down. Obviously, he told me he hasn't heard back from them just yet. Now, earlier, Marius, when we were here, we were told once the statue came down, it would leave the property, but that did not happen. So the statue is still on the property at the moment. We're working to find out what the next steps will be. Back to you.